I definitely feel stressed. Yeah, it's like we've been incredibly difficult and painful the last several months.
The robots are killing Tesla. In a rare win for humans over robots in the battle for labor efficiency, Wall Street analysts have laid down a compelling argument that over-automation is to blame for problems at the billionaire Elon Musk's electric car company. So what went wrong? The Tesla Model 3 production line is heavily automated, and right now that's a problem. During the company's third quarter earnings call, CEO Elon Musk told investment analysts that the $35,000 electric car, which launched this summer to much fanfare, has struggled to reach its lofty production goals because of issues with manufacturing. Automation will certainly prove faster in the long term, but in the short term, Tesla can't switch out its army of robots for humans. In early 2017, Elon Musk told stock analysts that Tesla's goal is to be the best manufacturer on Earth. He'd get there by inventing a factory so dense with robots and devoid of human beings it would resemble an alien dreadnought video game warship.
We call it the alien dreadnought. At the point at which the factory looks like an alien dreadnought, then you know you've won.
Speed, he said, is the ultimate weapon when it comes to innovation or production. Instead, Tesla this week was forced to bring the Fremont, California production line of its crucial mass-market Model 3 electric sedan to a complete halt. It is at least the second shutdown in the last 2 months. And in an internal email, Musk said Tesla will add workers and go to round-the-clock production to meet its goals. Officially, the company is describing the week-long shutdown of the Model 3 line as planned downtime to improve automation and systematically address bottlenecks in order to increase production rates. That is to say, the very innovation and competitive advantage that Musk says he's bringing to the car industry, his nearly fully automated plant in Fremont, California, is the reason Tesla is unable to scale quickly. According to the Bernstein analysts, it's the robots that can't pump out Tesla's highly anticipated Model 3s fast enough. The whole process is too ambitious, risky, and complicated. Bernstein analyst says, Tesla has tried to hyper-automate final assembly. We believe Tesla has been too ambitious with automation on the Model 3 line. Few have seen it, but we know this. Tesla has spent two times more than what a traditional OEM spends per unit on capacity. It has ordered huge numbers of KUKA robots. It has not only automated stamping, paint, and welding, as most other OEMs do, it has also tried to automate final assembly, putting parts into the car. It talks of two-level final lines with robots automating part sequencing. This is where Tesla seems to be facing problems, as well as in welding and battery pack assembly. Insiders in Tesla say automation and final assembly just doesn't work. But hang on a minute. Don't the big auto manufacturers automate too? Not quite. The world's best car makers, the Japanese, try to limit automation because it is expensive and is statistically inversely correlated to quality. Their approach is to get the process right first, then bring in the robots, the opposite of Musk's. It's not a problem that Tesla, a highly indebted company, can afford forever. The company's stock has cratered more than 25% in the past month on worries that it will yet again under-deliver on its Model 3 promises. Over the past few days, investors have been selling Tesla's debt in droves. On Tuesday, Moody's downgraded Tesla by one notch to B3, citing a significant shortfall in Model 3 production. During Tesla's fourth quarter earnings call, Musk told investors that factory model assembly was the biggest constraint on Model 3 production. There are tens of thousands of components in each car, he said, and the company can only move as fast as it can correct each problem area. One thing that makes it hard to solve problems in every area, according to Bernstein's analysts, is that they're all automated. Other car companies that have tried this, Fiat and Volkswagen, have also failed. What's more, Bernstein says, this is barely saving Musk money. Let's say there are 10 hours of labor in final assembly, the part of the production line where parts, interiors, and the powertrain are installed in a painted body shell. In a regular plant, final assembly typically has less than 5% of tasks automated. If Tesla attempts to automate 50% of these tasks, it could cut out 5 or so hours of labor. This might save $150 per car, assuming wage rates all in, of $30 USD per worker per hour. But while all that exotic capital might allow Tesla to remove five workers, it will then need to hire a skilled engineer to manage, program, and maintain robots for $100 an hour. So the net labor savings may only be $50 per unit. Yet putting the automation into the plant seems to involve an apparent capital cost that's 4,000 USD higher per unit of capacity than for a normal plant. If the product is built for 7 years, that's over $550 of additional depreciation per unit built. It's hard to see an economic case, even if somehow the Fremont Model 3 line can be made to work. So why exactly has Tesla taken this route? It's unclear. By the way, in 2017, Tesla bought automated manufacturing firm Perbix as it struggles with production. Another acquisition to help Tesla build the machine that makes the machine. Perbix is a private machining firm that makes automated equipment for factories. Perbix has been a Tesla supplier for almost 3 years, but the acquisition will allow the car maker to bring the production of more parts in-house. Tesla described the deal as a step further in its long-stated ambition to build the machine that makes the machine. The acquisition comes in the middle of a spell of bad news for Tesla production. Last year, the company reported a massive $619 million quarterly loss and said it would no longer be able to meet its goal of producing 5,000 Model 3 sedans per week. So in Musk's attempt to bring on the robot uprising that will revolutionize how we make cars, he's burned cash and baked in his own mistakes. If you think about it that way, we are just beginning to understand how much this will cost him. So we will leave it right here. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thumbs up if you liked it, subs if you loved it. See you guys next time.